So before we go ahead, how many people know about the Docker here? Great. How many people heard about the Kubernetes? Great. So now OpenShift, right? It's a Red Hat product, actually. And how we actually advertise it, it's like run Kubernetes with the enterprise stuff added to it, right? So we actually based our stuff on the Kubernetes and add some more enterprise value added, and then we tell the customers, or even we have the open source version of it, which we call Origin, right? Which we call Origin, OpenShift Origin, which actually we always make sure that it parallel to the Kubernetes development, right? Now, who am I? My name is Praveen Kumar, and then I works at Red Hat. I works in a team which is the developer experience group team, and we make sure that when developers start developing their applications, right, they're easy to deploy it over any PaaS infrastructure, or if they needed any run times, then we tell them, okay, we can use that, and so those kind of tooling where we work. What is Minishift actually? So how many of you heard about Minikube? Right. So it's the same thing like Minikube. We forked from the Minikube only, but in the OpenShift, what we do is that we use OC cluster up, which is what it do. It will actually start a cluster, one single node cluster of OpenShift, right, and locally. So and the underlying things is libmachine, which we are going to talk about. Now the question occurred, why we needed Minishift when we already tell users, okay, directly install OpenShift. The thing is that directly installing OpenShift, the configuration part and all those things are quite not user friendly. It takes some time to user to grab all those things, how to change the configuration, making sure the nodes are working, making sure the connections are working, right? For that, what we did is that what we actually do, we make sure that the things are already part of one single the tool which we are shipping, like Minishift, and user just have to do like Minishift start, and it will just start the cluster, and then user just have to worry about their application development instead of the configuration part of it, right? Now the same thing, why Minishift we use, single command, which is easy to use. Everything, whatever a developer usually require, it's already there. You don't have to install anything extra because the Minishift is written in Go, so static binary, right? So no other dependency. And then the benefit user will get is that they can run their application locally on the OpenShift before they move their application to the production level of OpenShift. In the production level, there are the operational team might have some different kind of security. Okay, this container doesn't run in this particular user permissions. This container doesn't run. So user can do all kind of experiments locally before they push it to the production scenario. So you don't believe me? That's fine. There is a demo. Let me just clear it. Very fast. I will try to do because I'm already we have less time. So I just did Minishift start. Can you see the screen? Should I just increase the font a little bit? So two things here. You can see it is starting mini OpenShift with the Hive hypervisor. How many of you know about Hive, right? So it's it's natively right now on the Mac. The support is there. It's on Beehive, based on Beehive, but it's open source. So people are using now to making sure that the things is work without any extra virtualization tool like VirtualBox or something else. So we are also using the same capability because libmachine already have those kind of capabilities to use. sorry guys. Live demo usually don't work very well, so let's hope. So it was, I think, because of network issue, but let's see if it start. Okay, before let it going to be here, let me just increase the font a little bit here. Just to overview about how, what are the options we have in the Minishift right now. So one, assume that you are running your cluster, right? Now you want to make some change in the configurations. So there is a something called config, right? Which will modify the Minishift configurations option. So like I right now I'm using Jive driver, but I want to switch on the VirtualBox. And next one, I always want to be the VirtualBox. So I can see a Minishift config set whatsoever, right? Whatever the driver I use. Then there is a console which will open the web console for the Minishift, and then delete is what it's supposed to be. Then Docker environment is that, like, if you want to add some more insecure registry, or if you want to add the proxy settings, or if you want to provide something else with the Docker environment variables, you can set it up. IP, provide the IP of the running cluster, logs, and all those things are there. What happened to it? Please don't do that. Okay, it started actually. It just terminal phased for some time. So now it started. So as I told, let's see. So so the IP which I got here is the cluster IP, the VM which is running inside the using the Jive. So what I can do is fast now. So. Okay, let me log out. So by default, we create a one user for the cluster, which is developer. Username and password will be developer. And by default, also under the user developer, we create a project called my project. So now what I will do is that very fast. Is deploy applications, right? So what I'll say, okay, I want to add something to the project. Now, what kind of project I want to deploy, right? And what are the strategy I can use to deploy my project or application? So let's say I have a Docker image already, right? I want to just deploy that Docker image. And my Docker image are on the Docker Hub, right? So I will say that I have a Docker image. I'm using a roadshow image, which we usually use for presenting during the roadshow for the OpenShift. So I'm using that image. I'll deploy it, search it out. Right? And then, so there are options, like if you have some, like in the Docker file, you can create the environment and then you can pass it along, right? So if you have environment variable, you can pass it along labels and all those things. So now I'll say create. Now you can see it's started, and you can see the continue to overview where it started the pod, right? Now you can see the log. Anyway, the application is up and running now. If I want to see the application, I have to create a route, because right now this application is what is inside registry, you can access it, but the creating is route is very easy. You can see this, you can just do a create route, and I don't want to do any extra things, it will create a route for me. Now I can access this application using this route. So when I click here, you can see this map visualizer which is on my local system working here, right? You can see in the street, you can see in the grayscale, right? So the map is working, all things locally working fine. Now, another thing that usually what developer actually do, they just want to commit their code to GitHub, right? And then they want that, okay, once the code is commit to the GitHub or any version control, it's supposed to have a webhook which will deploy the applications based on that. So what we can do is that, let's do fast. Assume I have a Python project, right? And I'm using the latest Python. I will again use a So right now the project which I'm deploying is a kind of backend service which is doesn't have any database, but it have the JSONs to coordinates of the national park which are there, which we can see in the map visualizer. So the GitHub URL is this. So it's very simple. I'm just telling the demo is only the purpose to understand how the things works in the OpenShift, how easy to the deploy the applications on the OpenShift. So I'll just create it. I'll just go to and start. So the application is running. If you want to see the logs for any application which you deployed, you can see. So what it actually do is that it clone the repository. Then there is some concept called S2I, which is source to image builder. What it do is that it will take your source, because we selected the Python 3.5, the base Python image will be there, which source to image understand that how to integrate that code, right? And where to put that code so that it will run as a Docker container. So once the container is up and running, it will post, I think it's successful already, so it will be available. So now you can see the pod is up and running, right? And it because we use the template which have already by default the route creation, we don't have to create the route. So, but come on.
The Wi-Fi's going up and down.
Come on. Yes, you're right. So the resolver which we are using, DNS resolver, it's actually need Wi-Fi. Come on. Cancel. Well, it was easy. Anyway, so this is the way. So the application is running up and running. Here you can see the pod is running. Right. Once the Wi-Fi up, I will show you it again. Okay. Not up. Okay. Let's go back to the slide. It's not up, right? I'll just turn it off. So that's how we actually deploy the application on OpenShift. The help section I already did. Now under the hood, like I talked about, it's forked with the Minikube, right? And then what it do is it runs the single node OpenShift cluster within a VM using the native hypervisor of the box. Like in Windows, if you want to run the Minishift, it will use the hypervisor will be Hyper-V. Right? In the Linux, if you use, it will use the KVM as a default. So you don't have to install any extra tooling around the virtualizations. And then use the libmachine to manage the VM management, because libmachine have different drivers for the different hypervisors, like KVM driver, it have Docker, what driver? It have Exive driver, and then the KVM drivers, right? And then it will use the cluster up for provisioning the OpenShift cluster, right? So once the VM is up, we just run open OC cluster up so that it will start the cluster. why Red Hat is actually investing for the Minishift? Because inside the Red Hat, we have a product called CDK, Container Development Kit. If anybody want to know more, I'll be outside. We can talk about it. But it's a zero price subscription-based things, which you have the Rail ISO. You can run your stuff on the Rail. And the OpenShift with the OCP, which is the OpenShift container platform, OpenShift. The downstream OpenShift will be there, right? OCP. Future roadmap. So we recently did the beta 5 release of it, and it's working pretty good. So these are the roadmap we have. So the people who use boot to Docker ISO, anybody use boot to Docker? right? So they have something, so they already use the different kind of VM drivers, like VirtualBox, they are using VM drivers, the VB guest to making sure the host and guest mounting happens without any problem. So we are actually, so and the thing is that it only happened with the VirtualBox, right? So what we are doing is that we want to make something like SSH way, the SSH FS way to, so that it will doesn't matter with the operating system which you are using, instead of that, okay, the SSH based sharing will be up and running for each and every operating system. So that thing. We have already ability to configure and patch the OpenShift master and node, and where can I get it? This is the GitHub URL. Go to releases, download the binary, start it. Community, we are very active. We crossed 300 stars, not that big, but yes, we are still counting. We are working towards it. We have a free node channel on IRC. Still not on Slack, but works fine. Mailing list, we have container tools at head.com in the mailing list right now. It's a public mailing list. You can join, ask questions. resources, we have a documentation page on the openshift.org/minishift. And then the current examples as per demo, which I showed you right now, is actually on that katacoda.com openshift. You can just run through it and you can see how the OpenShift actually works. Thank you. Any question? I think I was on time. Let's see. Little bit. Much, yeah.
Can I say cluster? What did you mean by cluster?
So the OC is the OpenShift client binary, which have the options called cluster. What it do is that it will just provision one cluster node on your local host, and then provision it. So, and the same thing which we use, because we don't want to invent same thing again. So we use the OC cluster. Okay. So thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.